Concept Media, and today he's going to be speaking about a topic that I absolutely love, about solution, about problems, figuring out problems before we start just building stuff, right? Let's give a warm welcome for Greg Kalin. In Arizona, which is like, oh, you're laughing.
and they showed me the door quickly. You know? So,
a lot of fun.
So who's this talk for? This talk is for anybody who is in front of clients, anybody who is passionate about WordPress, anybody who maybe runs an agency, maybe anybody who, you know, is talking about your passions or talking about what WordPress can do for a business and whatnot. So, big question, who are you? So raise your hands, how many business owners do we have in here? Oh, awesome, we have a lot. Cool. How many developers do we have in here? Jesus, don't you guys have someone better than me? The developers scare the shit out of me every time I speak. Don't you guys have to go like talk about Bloomberg somewhere?
Fan.
Yeah, right. But you know, he says he's a day trader. He day trades attention. get your Starbucks? Or here, you know, or are your Better Buds here locally? Exactly. So what, okay, this is a perfect discussion right now that we can kind of, you know, actually, I like this slide, I'm going to get right back to it. People are skeptical about things they do not understand. Right? So when you deal with somebody who dealt with that God, what happens?
If you are logical and...
Or creative.
Okay, well, I come from the logic side of being creative.
Cool.
So if you're logical and you give people a good sequence that they can understand and they can wrap their heads around, then you can talk them out of their crappy website. Unless they don't have the money and...
Give me one second here. Well, what makes a website crappy? I mean, let's hit that. What makes it crappy?
They told you what they wanted to hear.
Told you what they wanted to hear? Doesn't solve a problem? That's my favorite one right there.
Can't find it?
Doesn't work?
I recently encountered a client website where the entire thing was built. This took more effort than just building it in HTML. They injected the entire website in JavaScript.
Yeah. Shut the front door, she said. See, I'm from a different part of the country where we were just saying, shut the fuck up, really? that's incredible, right? But what happens to our community when we're dealing with that?
Somebody's convinced that person.
Exactly. Right.
That was the right way to go.
That's the right way to go about things.
So you have to convince them that it's not.
So exactly. So like, you know, I kind of got sidetracked here, but I love this thing. Well, what did you...
Well, basically, that scenario, the person who buys a site from the Starbucks expert, because they told that person what they wanted to hear, they reflected everything they asked for, forget about what's right or wrong. They just, sure, I'll do that.
And I'm going to get to this a little bit different, a little bit later in the presentation, but why did they come to that solution? Whose problem are they solving at that point? They're solving the room, right?
Yeah.
And what's that problem that they're solving?
They got the
money in their account. And listen, okay, we're mostly business owners in here, right? A good portion of us, right? How many times have you guys been awake? Like, I always call them ceiling fan thoughts. Like, laying in bed with a ceiling fan, and you're just like, holy shit, how am I going to make payroll this week? Or how am I going to make payroll next pay period? Or how am I going to do this? Or how am I going to do that? Right? I tell you how, when the easy way to go do it, go sell some shit to some fucking schlep, and they don't know any different.
Yep.
But that doesn't do anything for anybody. It doesn't better our community. It doesn't better your business. It definitely doesn't better WordPress. And what does it do? It puts us back to this.
Well, and the other thing is, in the long run, you're actually going to be making less money by selling a bad product.
100%. 100%. 100%. So,
So going back to that, so I encountered that problem where I came in after a snake oil salesman came in, and they didn't want to listen to a word I had to say because they used WordPress and it didn't work for them and they hated it.
It poisons our community, right? I'm sorry. It poisons you as a professional. It minimizes what we do as professionals. And like, look, let's face it here, right? We are a highly skilled group of individuals in this room.
Exactly.
I don't care what you do. I don't care what your expertise is. I don't care if you want to spend all day writing PHP. I don't care if you want to be a designer. I don't care if you want to do this. We're skilled individuals, one way or another, right? You're laughing at something. What do you think? Nothing? Okay. Well, maybe you had a thought you wanted to share. No. Sorry, Coach. But you know, we're a highly skilled group of individuals. That's exactly what it does. So now, they're skeptical of you because what you're saying is wrong because they've already been
building a website, you could build a website and make it look good, but maybe not be secure, maybe not function well, be fast.
I totally hear what you're saying, but I think that still remains to be seen.
I'm not saying it's going, but it's a potential issue that we're going to have to look at.
But it was a potential issue when the visual editor came on.
Yeah.
I mean, it's just, you know what I'm saying? When, I've had people say, oh, you built something on WordPress, it's just moving, dragging, and dropping, and doing videos. Well, kind of sometimes. Yeah, but CNN.com is built on WordPress. Agency that Dre used to work for, it built some big shit. Right? That's not drag and drop. That's not, you know what I mean? So it's like, while I hear what you're saying, I think that it remains to be seen.
Well, instead it's a fear. It's not something that,
right.
Or it's a concern.
It's a concern. And it's a valid concern. It's a valid concern. Yeah.
As a designer, it's going to be my life a whole lot easier.
Okay.
It's going to allow me to be a lot more flexibility to be more creative.
Okay.
That's how I see it.
All right.
So,
God, Gutenberg is like, who's waiting for Gutenberg? Who's got the countdown until Gutenberg? There we go, all right. I knew that I was a super hot topic. It's like, it remains to be seen how it's going to help you, how it's maybe going to bring people in that don't belong in here. The common buying cycle? No, come on, we're talking, let's do this.
Well, so I can say the antidote to fear is to educate yourself, okay? So if anybody who cares about Gutenberg, go out and learn about it. And don't fear it. I mean, educate yourself and learn about it, and then you can master or control that.
Yeah. Who remembers the release of 4.0? And what was the big thing about them? Was the post types? Or 3A, whatever. It's your first WordCamp. How the hell do you know? You know what I mean? Like, I think that we are all. I think that unless you're on the core team, unless you mess with it, I think that a lot of things remain to be seen. And education is a key factor to get
voted
out.
It's Y2K all over again. Gutenberg is
Y2K. It's Y2K. I'm not that old.
Yeah.
You had a scratch on your nose, didn't you? Talks about common buying cycle. And what it is people want to do business with people they know, like, and trust. That's only 75% correct. Now, my math is not skewed. I understand there's only three things. If you're a math magician, it's going to be 66%. People want to do business with people who can solve their problem that they know, like, and trust. Solve the problem is the key. So the thing is from there, the buying cycle is solve problem, get them to know you, like you, trust you. Then they're going to meet with you. They're going to hire you. Hopefully they hire you more than once, and then they're going to refer you. So the way that I position that is, in a more clever way, is know you, like you, trust you, try, buy, repeat, refer. That's the mindset we all want to go. That's the lifeblood of our business. No one likes to be sold, but people like to buy. True, not true?
True.
Anybody not like to buy anything? Like what we were talking about, there's no real barrier to entry. WordPress is open source. Wi-Fi is free. You have a laptop, or if you're really good with a smartphone, I don't know. You know what I mean? You can go ahead, and you can get into this arena. But you're not going to be one of us. A highly skilled professional. So, here's a mask game here. I had to look this up last night. This guy's named Gene Rayburn. Jay Rayburn. I remember being a kid with this thing on, but I forgot his damn name. I didn't watch it in black and white. So, there are only a couple goals, I say, in any website that you're building. And there are only, like, in my mind, there's only really three goals. There's three goals that are creating content for search positioning, for branding, to show that you're a subject matter expert, to build a community around your product, service, and brand. WordPress does that great. The Humane Societies do that great. And conversion. conversion, in my mind, and the way that I'm using it, is getting a user to behave in an intended manner. So, conversion could be getting them to sign up for a newsletter, get them to buy something, get them to fill out a contact form. Anything, that's conversion to me. That's what we do. Any goals I'm leaving out? That's conversion. Okay, typically, every once in a while, I get somebody who says, my goal, the goal of my website is revenue, generating revenue. I always say, generating revenue is not a goal in itself. Generating revenue is a byproduct of meeting one of these goals. Thanks. I appreciate that, thank you. So what are common business problems that we all experience in here? Right? What are common business problems that we hear about when we're meeting with clients, potential clients, or anybody at a happy hour, or whatever? The ones that I typically hear are these six. Your brand is invisible. They don't know who you are. They don't even know what you do or you have a website. Lack of revenue, that's a business problem. It's not. Brand perception. Lack of loyalty. Inferior product, inferior team, inferior XYZ. That's a business problem. An inexperienced team, an inexperienced business. Any other business problem that people face that they hear about? These are the six that popped in my head when I was making this. Lack of time. Business problem. Lack of time. That's a great one.
Lack of direction.
Lack of direction.
I've had companies that
are
really unclear what they do.
Unclear what they do? That's kind of like invisible, like that one, but yeah. Where it's kind of, it's like, yeah, that, absolutely, I know what you're saying with that. Yep.
I've had a lot of companies where the problem they're having is trying to transition into the modern world, so getting into things like online payments and getting people younger to actually buy their product.
Right, that's a good one. So, yep.
Lack of support.
Lack of support? That's like also falls into inexperience a little bit, but here we go with this, right? How many of these can be solved by what we do? I don't think, if you have an inferior product, there's nothing anybody can really do in this room to help you. I mean, we can position it differently. You know, I did go to school for marketing, so I do. If you have an inexperienced team, how, you know, yeah.
That's like, building on that, there's a lot of people who have, you know, they have a product or their site or whatever it is, their business structure, and they're trying to improve something that's just fundamentally broken. It's like trying to put a new roofing on a house with a crumbling foundation.
Yep.
You gotta have something that's built from the ground up to be a good.
She said lipstick on a pig. I always say wax on pinto. But who remembers the pinto? We're pinto, right? Alright, you guys are my age, I guess. So here's a reality check. Are we cool? Any? Are we all right? Everybody with me? Nothing's like, I'm not in outer space yet? What's not a business problem? What's not a problem for the client? So actually, let me back up here. So a couple of these, I think that these two are operational problems, and the other are web/marketing problems. You can't, your great website that you built is not gonna cure or fix a shitty organization. No matter how you try, no matter how much money they spend, they throw at you, eventually they're not going to be a good client for you because no matter what you do, it's a failure. It's not a success story. You know, we want to work on success stories. Who here has had a great success story with WordPress for a client? You know, something you're proud of. A lot of us. And that's pretty cool. But, you know, I believe in collaboration. I think collaboration is greater than competition. So if you can collaborate with the operational side of things or sales side of things, and I would just fire a client in my agency because the operations side wouldn't get the hell out of the way of the marketing side. Because the operations thought that they could do marketing when marketing, while we had internal discussions from meetings about their operations, we never said, you need to do this. You need to do that. That employee is not, that's not our business. We expertise and what they need.
That's not their problem.
Those are problems that a lot of people I see, and I hate to say the Starbucks, you know, developer or whatever, because I work at a coffee shop lots of times too, but you know what I mean. When I say that in jest, and I mean somebody who is going in there, oh, I can build you a website for $300. How many pages does that? Oh, that's 3,000. Perfect. Oh, it needs a rank number one? Sure. Mm-hmm. I guarantee you top rankings for these search terms. I'll bet. Anybody ever hear that from a competition? Like, I guarantee you it won't. Run, man. You know, I try to run away from those people holding my wallet. my hand in my back pocket, make sure they don't take it. But the problem is never that the people you're talking to do not have what you're selling. That's not a business problem. A lot of times people will say, oh, well, the problem is you don't have a website. Problem is you don't have good marketing. Problem is da-da-da-da-da. That's not the problem. The problem is you're invisible because you don't have a website. Or nobody knows who the hell you are because you have no presence over here. That's the problem. Also not problems. You're broke. Your business, you know, needs to make rent. You know, you're not making payroll. All that stuff. They're not problems. The problems that keep us up at night as business owners, right? But they're not client problems. You can't sell to your problems. You can't sell solutions to someone else to solve your own problems. You can. You're going to do it once. They're never going to be a repeat client. They're never going to refer you anywhere, right? So let's crack the code a little bit. Let's look at this a little bit differently. And just like a quick brand game here. So just a change of paradigm here. And it looks like I don't even have to do this because you guys seem to be on the same page. It's pretty cool. Red Bull, what is it? What kind of company is this? What do they do? Red Bull is a media company that sells an energy drink. 100%. Who said action sports? Somebody. Well, exactly. They are so immersed in skateboarding, motocross, skydiving, weird stuff I don't even know what to call it. Right? Plane races, the flute. I used to tell them, but the flute talk? Everybody know what a Red Bull Flutog is?
That is so cool.
They build these like
big platforms.
They build these like, it's kind of like a soapbox derby, only they have to fly in the air and they all together. It's like GoPro. What's GoPro? It's a camera company, right? It's a content creation company. That's what they saw. That's a problem they saw. They help us create content. And Nick Woodson, actually the CEO, he did a 60 Minutes interview a while ago, and he said they actually think that GoPro sometimes is a content enabling company. Does anybody have a GoPro in here? Okay. Out of you guys, how long have you been using it? Anybody like from like version like 1, 2, or 3? How hard is it to get content off of that goddamn thing?
It doesn't even get content, barely even shows up.
Right.
640 by 480.
So. Yeah, exactly. I mean, it is like, it's a content enabling company, man. They help you. Great, they help you create content, but then it's like, what are you gonna do? This company, what are they? They're a lifestyle company. Lululemon. Did you see?
Oh, you do.
Who's ever seen this logo before? Cool, good, awesome. Lululemon is a, it's a fashion company. They make clothes for people with active lifestyles. Yeah. So, but what they are is they're a lifestyle company. You see somebody wearing a Lululemon logo, you know that they're in a certain thing. So anyway, just some examples of this pattern. So let's talk about your company. Who's business owners? Who wants to share something about your company? What do you do? First of all, what's your name? I feel like I should know you.
Bob.
Bob, right?
Yeah.
Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you. Now I feel like you're. Everybody, Bob in the front row? What do you do?
We're an agency. We do digital media marketing and video production, photography, web development.
Have you been listening to me? You solve goddamn problems.
Yeah. I know, I'm struggling with that.
Okay. But that's what it is. If you reposition that and you start asking the questions to the client, and you say, You know, instead of, you know, they come to you for video. What did they tell, why do they want to make the video?
Yeah, actually, I did come up with something I forgot because you put me on the spot, sort of, but, no, I mean, not in a bad way, but.
You're on the spot?
I was thinking, you know, something more like we help people tell their stories online. That would be more of in the direction that you're.
Absolutely. But how do you do that? Through video.
Yeah.
Anybody else?
I think you know the punchline here.
Yeah, tell me about your company, what you do.
I'm a mailchimp expert. I help people deliver or communicate via email.
There you go. You help people, you the problem you're solving is you're making people top of mind. You're making your brands top of mind when they get the emails. As long as you're doing right and you're doing everything, you're not, you know, you're following canned spam regulations and all that stuff, you're not getting, you know, too many spam.
It's
you know, you
want
to do
the
you're right. Anybody else? Yeah.
We're a brand management and brand strategy with project management agency, but we don't use the word agency.
But you don't use.
We don't use the word agency.
You don't. I hate that.